Restoring the environment can be quite the task, even harder than restoring all of your phone's contacts. Let's check out this next segment on environmental restoration. California has almost 50 million acres of protected outdoor spaces. From world-famous national parks, to scenic coastlines, to towering woodlands, even to local parks and trails. Every year, to help conserve and restore those special places, thousands of young adults sign up with the California Conservation Corps. Today, we're in Southern California, talking to Ariana Carranza to find out how CCC members like her are making a difference.
I was inspired to join the Corps because I loved how they gave back to California, which is where I was born and raised. As a Corps member, I do lots of stuff. Conservation is probably my favorite. We are able to plant, remove invasive species, and also help our local community. What I love most about my work is that I get to be outside every day. I was never somebody to be indoors, so just being outside is probably one of the biggest pluses.
California Conservation Corps members, like Ariana, work to conserve and restore California's natural ecology by maintaining parks and trails, planting trees, improving fish habitats, and even helping first responders during fires, earthquakes, and floods. Today, Ariana's team is working at the Aliso and Wood Canyons Wilderness Park in Laguna Niguel. She's going to show us how a few small plants can make a big difference for California's environment and its citizens.
So invasive plants are plants that are not supposed to be here. These invasive plants compete for resources and don't allow our native plants to germinate, which means that native plants, which act as a food source, won't be there. And animals and bugs that rely on the native plants won't survive. Our job today is to replenish that native food source. It provides a home for biodiversity and wildlife. So me and my crew will help restore this natural area back to its original state by planting native shrubs and trees and grasses. Let's get to work.
To make sure they're doing what's best for specific environments, the CCC works with local experts and ecologists to pick the right plants for the right areas.
This is the California blackberry. Animals love it. It makes delicious blackberry fruit. And right now we have a pre-watered hole. There needs to be water in it so that the roots can have something to grab onto.
Before actually placing the blackberry plant, Ariana makes sure that the dirt is compressed and that the plant will sit about level to the ground. She takes the plant out nice and gently, places it in its new home, and loosens up the roots a bit. Ariana fills up the hole and compresses the soil.
You want to make sure you compress just so that there's no air holes because that can rot the roots at the end.
Finally, she makes a small sloped barrier around the plant.
So right now I'm building a barrier that slopes inland just so that any water, any rain that comes in goes directly into the roots.
But Ariana isn't just making a new home for the native plants like this California rosebush. She's also getting rid of some unwanted visitors.
While planting, I also make sure to try to remove the invasive species. Right here we have black mustard. We try to take it out just as much as we can because it competes for resources and actually outgrows the native plants.
And these plants not only provide food for native animals, they also provide resources for nests and dens. And the plants don't just benefit wildlife. They also help protect the soil itself.
So right here we have mugwort. These roots go so far down that they hold the soil where the stream can't cause erosion.
Once the plants are all in the ground and they've been watered, there's one more step.
The last step is plant shelters. Plant shelters actually help these native plants from getting eaten by bunnies or other little animals or critters. Also, it works and has a greenhouse effect so that the plants can grow faster and healthier. And at the end of today, we will have planted 12,000 plants in just 3 weeks. That feels pretty good. So conservation work like this is very important in your cities and neighborhoods because it gives us an idea of what the land used to look like before we were here. It lets us see endemic species and endemic wildlife. For example, there's endangered birds that are coming back because of our work. With the growth of cities and population, it's really important to keep places like this around. So a good way to advocate is to go volunteer and go visit your parks. Build a community garden. All you need to do is start somewhere because it's important to preserve our natural, beautiful open spaces like this.